If you thought EA was the most transparently evil and money-focused collection of reptilians, think again. Blizzard just told EA, hold my loot box. I'm about to ruin this gamer's whole career, and ruin it they did. Now, Blizzard are the people behind a game called Overwatch. Maybe you've heard of it. It's the game where Tracer's gay, except not in China, because, you know, we gotta make that money. They also made World of Warcraft like a billion years ago, and even though people were dying for them to bring back a classic mode, they resisted for years, and then when they did, it's the most popular thing in the world. Did you know Blizzard also makes a card game? And that a Grandmaster was removed because of his views on Hong Kong. Blizzard took the side of China and rescinded this dude's prize money and has suspended him from professional play for an entire year following a recent interview. In his face, Blizzard aligns itself with China, cause they care about that money. And this isn't an out of season April Fool's joke. They don't care about you, homie. I'm sitting over here thinking I'm being too critical of the new season of South Park. We're only two episodes in and I'm thinking this just isn't funny. But how relevant is the Chinese market and how apparently it dictates what everybody's gonna do regardless of whether or not you're forsaking humanity? Is this a good look, Blizzard? Is this gonna pan out well for you? I hope the Chinese market is worth it, because you're kicking yourself square in the nuts. Square in the nuts. World news. Blizzard suspends Hearthstone player for supporting Hong Kong. The top comment reads, not a good look, Blizzard. I thought a mobile version of Diablo was as low as you could go. A response reads, mobile Diablo will have a real money auction house where you can bid on the organs of political prisoners. No. They are unaware volunteers. It's all a social experiment. Apparently, the two Taiwanese guys that were doing the sportscaster thing for the match were also fired. They didn't even say anything. Ooh boy, looks like some people are canceling their WoW subscriptions in protest. Ugh, things are getting too spicy for the pepper. That's right, dadders. Wish I could refund my Overwatch. Ugh, how you like that, Tracer? Ugh, I'm already Tracer. You should've picked Chung Wai. That's his name. And Blizzard said, nah man, they gotta pick China. They about to make Chung Wai go bye-bye. They said it, not me. You know, terrible. Can you believe it? You know, this is the same Blizzard that thinks the okay hand sign is grounds for dismissal, you toxic gamer bastards. I'm pretty sure Blizzard hates gamers. Well, you know what, Blizzard? Now the feeling's mutual. Let the fastening of your clown shoes begin. Here's my impression of Blizzard.
Those fat, toxic, neckbeard baby gamers will get over this in a week. Ugh. Now back to my swimming pool full of money.
Like Scrooge McDuck? Is that a reference that's too old for people these days? How about the emote where you make it rain in Fortnite? You know, is that recent enough? Let me get that emote on screen. Boom, there it is. Editing.
roll up and get your spicy moderator deleted comments.
Damp Knickers says, wow, I could sound, it's Knickers, YouTube. You know, I'm black, what can I even say that? You know, but I'm gay too, just for that extra sheet of protection.
It's completely effing heartless and disgusting.
I saw someone say if Bad Boy Germany was alive and well today, people would still be scrambling to sell them oil.
Ooh-wee. Blizzard-like cowards have disabled comments for the first time in any of their little news things here, and puts out a statement that makes it pretty clear that this was entirely their choice. Section 6.1 in their little statement reads, engaging in any act that in Blizzard's sole discretion brings you into public disrepute, offends a portion or group of the public, or otherwise damages Blizzard's image will result in the removal from the Grandmasters and a reduction of the player's prize total to $0 USD, in addition to other remedies which may be provided for under the handbook and Blizzard's website terms.
Drink up, said China. You like what you taste in.
So where does this leave us?
Man, the odds are if you're still playing Overwatch or World of Warcraft, nothing can affect you. You've got like armor with enchantments on it to just make everything bounce off of you. You know what I'm talking about? But if you know what's going on in Hong Kong, and the summarized version is people are fighting for their rights out there. Not like, oh man, I want to be able to play with my marbles on this side of the street type rights. This is human rights they out there fighting for. Odds are you've already had to make an effort to ignore all of the videos of the violence and police brutality that you typically only see against dark people like me. You know what I'm talking about? I said it. This man Chung Wai, though, known as Blitz Chung, spoke out in support of some of the protests going on, and Blizzard decided, you know what, boy, I'ma flex on y'all that I really got the biggest hammers out here, and they banned the crap out of this dude. They punished the hell out of him. They revoked his prize money. There he goes for a year. Watch out, boy. Blizzard will poop you up, and all because they were worried about protecting their wallet. I hope you start to see a trend, because something tells me this is only the beginning. As excited as I am to see Blizzard's slimy response to all of this nonsense, the tragedy is the tragedy. Blizzard will not be affected by whatever sandy panties this situation creates. People need to vote with their wallets, stop supporting Blizzard, and they're probably just gonna keep doing what they doing. That being said, you have to wonder sometimes if all of us dropped out, would China just be enough? They really are sacrificing what it means to be human. These are like democratic things that we're trying to support out here. It wasn't like a call for violence or a call to arms. It was just what I would consider censorship. And I could tell you some things about Apple and the NBA and Blizzard and Google, but you know, I don't need to bury myself any further on the on whatever list that YouTube probably has me on right now. So look, as a warning, vote with your wallet. If you don't support it, don't support it. You know what I'm saying? Because the sick and scary ass thing about this, and I have to be extremely real with you right now, I hate to go full Wings of Redemption and hit you with the real talk, but this company doesn't even care about pretending anymore. You know what I mean? It's so transparent. With Pokemon, we can get upset that the game isn't what we wanted it to be, but at the end of the day, these video games don't account for like a half of the revenue. They're like a joke. In the shadow of the merchandise, right? So when you think about Blizzard, who hasn't made a good game in what? You know what I mean? And maybe they're not interested in that. Maybe Blizzard has gone full Konami because as far as they're concerned, they can make more money in this market. We gonna make mobile games. Are you excited about these mobile games? You ain't excited about these mobile games? Maybe we tell you what to be excited about. Nah, you think you want it, but you don't. You know what I mean? Whoa. How long y'all gonna be trying to swallow that horse-sized pill, you know, before you're like, But you know what? You're Blizzard. And regardless of whether or not your stocks are tanking, you and Activision, losing fans and customers all over the place, are going to start banning people. Did you say something our Chinese shareholders wouldn't like? You're getting banned. Supporting democracy. Not in my video game. You know what? I have to whisper something in parcel tongue to my Slytherin leash holders. Listen, don't support this, you know? I'm not trying to tell you what to do. You're a grown ass man or woman, or maybe you're a little kid. Listen, Billy, don't support me, okay? You know, do it. But like it, subscribe it. This is sick. So if you played a little bit of Modern Warfare, you played a beta or something, and you liked it, you know, that was a game that took you back like a Ratatouille gift to when you were young, okay, and you feel like you're gonna have yourself a holly jolly Christmas, a great experience, I hope you got a bunch of sandbags, because the flood of loot boxes will be upon you when Activision, ooh, it opens the floodgates of gimme your money. Bro, I might just, you know, watch Nightmare Before Christmas until I can't breathe, and that'll be the end of it. You know what I mean? See you guys later.
I made it to 10 minutes.